Hey Cafe Crew, in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to do focus stacking inside of Photoshop so you can blend multiple photos and get it all in focus. So one of the challenges is doing close-up photography and getting everything in focus, especially if you've got a wide open aperture. So here's this shot, this part's in focus and everything else is blurry. And right here, now this is in focus and everything else is blurry. So the way to do this is to shoot multiple photos. In this case, I've got one photo here where our focus is right here. A second photo where we've pushed the focus back further. And then a third photo where the focus is all the way back. And then we can blend these together and have everything in focus. Okay, so one of the challenges is notice is the alignment is way off between these. So what we're going to do is select the three images and we're going to first of all align them. Now you would think it'd be difficult, but it's not. It's super easy. We just go up here and then we're just going to choose to go to edit and then we're going to choose auto align layers. And we're just going to choose auto. You could do reposition, but auto is going to work fine. And we're just going to let it think and let's have a look. There we go, look at that. Photoshop has done a great job of aligning these three photos. So now we want to get all the areas that are sharp together to try and reduce this depth of field effect. Now, we could start blending with masks or we could just use this feature, which is a lot easier. We're just going to choose edit and we're going to choose auto blend layers. And we make sure we turn on stack images, click OK. Let Photoshop think it through a little bit. And bam, it does it all for us. So look at that. So now we can see all the areas have been blended together to get it nice and sharp. Now, if you wanted the whole photo in sharp, you would just take a few more pictures. So let's just kind of finish this up a little bit. I'm just going to crop this. So I choose the crop tool and we're just going to crop it in a little bit and maybe crop it there and just hit enter. All right, so now we want to apply a camera raw filter to everything, but notice it's on three different layers. So rather than blend these together, I'm just going to choose convert to smart filters from the filter menu. And this will put them into one smart object. The other way you could do it is you could just right click on there and choose convert to smart object. You would get exactly the same result. So now we're going to choose filter. We're going to get a camera raw filter. And now, you know, we can recover our highlights a little bit. We can open up our shadows a bit. Give it some whites, give it some blacks. Definitely thicken that up, give it some clarity. I want this to be a little bit crunchy because of the type of image it is. Maybe take the vibrance down a little bit, just reducing the amount of color, and also punch the contrast a bit more. Throw a vignette around the edge. Let's just choose here. We want to use the post crop vignette. Just darken down those edges and click OK. And there we go. We've got our final image. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this. Hit that subscribe button right now. Become part of the Cafe Crew. Get a new tutorial every single week. If you like this tutorial, smash that like button into dust. Add a comment. Let's get a discussion going. Let me know what you'd like to learn, what you like, what you don't like. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.